I spent 14 years at Apple. I was a solutions engineer to begin with, then a national consulting engineer supporting customers in all kinds of industries worldwide and helping them work through how to get Apple devices deployed at scale. So when I think about something like wallpaper, there's a lot of small details that make a big difference, and your corporate branding is extremely important to you. You have to get this right. If you don't look good on the device that's customer facing, that's not good for your business. Setting the wallpaper sounds straightforward. You send an image to a device and it's going to set the wallpaper. But there's a lot that goes into a wallpaper itself. The size of the image, like the proportions of the image, what is in the image itself, if you have a logo, is it in the right spot or not? Will it be visible on the device or not? And quite often, admins find themselves getting a wallpaper image from, say, their graphics team. You try and apply it to a number of devices and turns out it doesn't fit. I want them to have an easy time. They get a file, they try it, and it shows right away if it's going to work on a device. And that was a core design principle of our wallpaper library item. So here we are in the add to library item section. I selected wallpaper. So let's add a wallpaper library item to our library. So first off, you want to give this a title, right? Your corp wallpaper. You'll select the blueprint you want to use. In this case, we'll use the exec team. And then you dive right in. So you have access to this view in the wallpaper library item that we designed to try and make your life easier. So here you get to drop a file in and see what the result is. So as you see, we have device outlines that show you what this will look like on an actual physical device. So you don't have to deploy to an actual physical device. You get the result right away on the screen here. We want to make sure that you see the result right away, because if you switch, for example, to landscape mode here, you notice that's not going to work. So what you can do then right away is say, well, I need a better fit, better file. So if I select a different file and bring it in, so drop that in, I have a little more of a generic file going on with my icon fully centered. It's not impacted by date and time at the top of the view. Even if I switch portrait or landscape, this file works, right? If I were to bring it in to the home screen, that's still problematic because now my icon is impacted by the app icons on the physical device. But this is what's going to look like in the real world. I put a lot of effort in to make sure that what you see here is exactly what you'll get on a device. So what I'll do here, instead of using this busy view on the home screen, I'll select something a little more generic and less impacted by icons. So in this case, there's no icon, there's no corporate logo to be taken over by icons on the home screen. So that gives you a much better view and a much better looking corporate device. My corporate image is preserved on lock screen. I'm going with something a little more generic on the home screen. Some tips and things to keep in mind. You typically want to use a PNG, a JPEG, or even a BMP file. It's good to keep an aspect ratio that's close to 4:3 for iPad, for example. We limit your file size to 5 megs, which we think is reasonable. Anything bigger than that might start impacting your network traffic and time it takes to deploy to devices. So those are the kinds of things you want to keep in mind. Try out a few files in here right away. We'll tell you what works, what doesn't. It'll help you provide better guidance to your graphics team as they produce files for you.